What's going on here? Another new update of After Effects? Yes, and this time we've got new toolset for 3D compositing and couple of extra cool things. Here is the full report. When you add new GLB or GLTF files with embedded animation to your timeline, you'll see a new animation options menu where you can select an included animation to play back. This allows you to bring characters to life, make objects fold or unfold, as well as time remap the animation so you can loop it or play it faster or slower. Using the advanced 3D renderer, you can set any 3D layer as a shadow catcher that can catch shadows cast by 3D models, but are otherwise transparent. It's a great way to make 3D model look like it's part of a 2D video or image, and you can also control the color of the shadow, as well as its opacity. Wow! You can now use depth maps to create more realistic composites by simulating real-world camera settings for 3D renderers, or to apply effects to a portion of a 3D scene based on its depth. The supported effects are in the first category, 3D channel, and you can use them to create depth of field, fog, or 3D transitions. Do you like the properties panel? I do. I'm using it all the time. This is why I'm so happy that now it works with lights and cameras, which can save you clicking, twirling, and minimize your mouse motion across the app. A minor feature, but I'm going to use it every day. You can now add OBJ models from your CC libraries. Open the Libraries panel and simply drag and drop your 3D model into the Project panel or Comp window. But how do you get OBJ models into your CC libraries? Great question. One way is to drag the model from the Project panel to the Libraries panel, or you can use Adobe Stock Collection for free or premium 3D models, and then once you license and save it, you will also get the option to add this to your library folder. This is a great way to share 3D assets with your team, as well as organize and hard them for yourself. There's an impressive array of animation presets designed to streamline your creative projects. From infographics and numbers to transitions and textures, these presets aim to give you a strong starting point for commonly used elements while also providing the control you need to customize them to the needs of your project. You can find them inside the Animation Presets folder or use Bridge to preview them. You'll find dynamic lines, charts and graphs, text boxes, numeric counters, textures and transitions, all of which are both cool and highly customizable. Finally, there are also two new scripting hooks. One to get the fonts being used in the project and the other one to replace fonts. So this is what's new in 24.5 in a nutshell. If you want to dive deeper, I got several tutorials that articulate the new features in greater detail. Links to everything in the description box right under the most important two buttons in the world, like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching and enjoy this fantastic release of After Effects.